60th anniversary of Windsor Park United Church Women, even though we're a year late. Parts of this service were written and used with permission from Marilyn Bubar, Keswick Ridge United Church Women, Elaine Burroughs, Maritime UCW, and Ruth Kennedy Winslow, the UCW in Prince Edward Island. The lovely mum plant you see here is from the UCW. Going through papers, albums, etc., it was and is amazing what Windsor Park UCW has done and accomplished over these many years. As you go downstairs later for refreshments, please enjoy browsing through the many albums downstairs. Following the service, the church executive is providing refreshments, and they have asked us if we would make our way downstairs and be seated first before getting your coffee. Thank you. Please join me in the call to worship. Women's Aid and Women's Missionary Society gather together. They had a vision. Young women and seasoned members gathered. They had a vision. In 1962, United Church Women was born. They had a vision. We gather to celebrate 60 years of service. We have a vision.
Let us pray. We celebrate the ladies gone before us. We celebrate the ladies who did the hard work to allow us to be the organization we are today. We give thanks to the families who supported them in their endeavors while eyeing the goodies on the counter that were going to the church. For their energy, vision outreach, and pastoral care, we give thanks. Be with us through the challenges of this moment in time as we celebrate, reflect, and renew our purpose and vision. Amen.
Part of the history of our UCW.
Our purpose: to unite women of the community of faith for the total mission of the church and to provide the means through which we may express our loyalty and devotion to Jesus in Christian witness, study, fellowship, and service. And our vision, as women of faith, we believe in nurturing Christian spirituality by reaching out through commitment and devotion to all God's people in the promotion of truth, justice, peace, caring, and respect for all throughout the earth, God's world. We believe in honoring God the Creator and loving others through generous giving and joyful living. And we believe in affirming and strengthening ourselves, both individually and together, through creative study, prayer, and action. And our opening hymn is, "There's a Voice in the Wilderness Calling."
Oh, was formed in June 1925, the two major women's organizations continued. There was the Women's Missionary Society, WMS, which focused on the worldwide mission and education. The other group was the Women's Association, WA, which focused on the needs of the local congregation and community. In some communities, it was the Ladies' Aid and other local women's groups. From the Voices of United Church Women for All Church Purposes, the Women's Missionary Society, WMS, had a budget of $1.5 million a year and a staff of 165 people at work in 80 centers across Canada. With 97 active missionaries around the world as nurses, doctors, teachers, etc., they also helped to set up a network of study groups to help groups learn about mission work. The world kept changing, and so did the women's groups over the years. Let's see. From the book, Ordinary Heroes, page 21, we learn that in 1960, the United Church General Council approved the formation of a new organization for women to share in a much more meaningful way in the work of the church within the congregation, presbytery, conference, and in the various boards of the church under the General Council. This meant that the Women's Association, WA, and the Women's Missionary Society, WMS, would be united under one name. The United Church Women was created on January 1st, 1962 by joining together the Women's Missionary Society and the Women's Association to unite women, the congregation for the total mission of the church. With any new organization within the church, there would have been some resistance, anger, and grief about the former groups, but the women moved on.
We don't have placards, but I'm the present. Virginia was the past. So you're going to get all phases. A lot has happened in 60 years. The roles of women have changed. How the United Church is organized has changed. There are Marthas and Marys in our UCW. We need the action and the prayerfulness to carry on our work. UCW groups provide hospitality, informal pastoral care, and outreach by providing for funeral lunches, anniversaries, and all sorts of other events, such as rummage sales, cookie walks, and we catered monthly meals to the AOTS, the men's club, for many years until they had to disband. Teas for all seasons have been held here, and the list goes on. The events raised funds from which the church and others benefited. United Church Women have prepared and led many worship services over the years. You all know about the World Day of Prayer held each March. And I would be remiss not to mention the deep and special friendships created among the women of our UCW. Over 60 years, they have been very special. Every UCW within their community of faith has stories to tell of their work, some funny, some serious, but all showing their commitment to the life and work of their congregation and to the world beyond their walls.
How do the UCW members use their time and talents as the groups are aging? United Church Women have certainly contributed their time, talents, and treasures to the United Church in a big way over the past 60 years. Millions of dollars have been given to the Mission and Service Fund for the many ministries across Canada and around the world. Millions of dollars in volunteer time and money have been contributed to the local churches for them to continue their work in the communities where the churches were located. How can the Marthas and Marys continue their work in these pandemic times? The future of the UCW has been impacted by COVID-19 that we have been experiencing since March of 2020. With different regulations across the country from day to day, week to week, and month to month. Windsor Park has been no exception. Mask on, mask off, physical distancing, vaccinations, the ever-changing numbers for public places, including the churches. It is difficult to maintain momentum when things keep changing. Maybe the UCW needs to start new programs. Lunches out, book studies, short-term studies, related to Easter, creation time, or Christmas. Perhaps new leadership will emerge from these projects. More people may become involved with short-term projects. UCW members need to continue mentoring other women and men of the congregation in how to organize and run events, since that is something that UCW members are good at. Share recipes. How to cook potatoes for potato salad without the scum on top. How many sandwiches and sweets are needed for a reception of 100? How does the dishwasher work? How do you clean the dishwasher? There are all kinds of ways that knowledge can be passed on without having to do the hard labor. Perhaps a little Bible of tips and tricks? United Church women have decades of wisdom and experience that can be shared with these folks newer to the United Church, and what is involved in the life and work of a congregation. The church needs both Marys and Marthas and Marys, as United Church women are leaders. We need to keep connected, phone, email, Zoom calls, whatever. Keep in touch with the members of your group. Please join us as we sing, "Christ Has No Body Now But Yours."
We welcome with gifts of the mind and the spirit. We come with tangible gifts that can be put to work in our communities of faith and with mission and service. These gifts will enable our communities of faith to live to their mission, and our mission and service gifts to go to ministries across Canada and around the world, providing hope to many. Let us now receive these gifts. Amen.
We said, all the members of the UCW who are here today and who helped organize the service and participated in the service. So, and we did it. We had our first service without Patrick.